Hey guys, Aubrey from MikeShreve.com here. We're going to do another Photoshop file, show you how to edit the text in another banner, this one right here. So we're going to go ahead and click that. We're going to open it with Photoshop. Again, like always, I'm on a Mac. You might be on a PC, totally fine. I'm using Adobe Photoshop CS6. You might be using another version or even Photoshop Elements. This should work roughly the same, no matter what version you're using. You'll probably get this error that says that your text layers might contain fonts that are missing. That's okay, we'll get there. So you have your file, it comes up here. You will notice that you have these layers over here. So the first order of business that we're going to change is this right here, this logo. I'm actually gonna zoom in. The shortcut for that would be on a Mac is Command plus. That'll zoom us in, maybe not so far, so that we can see it a little bit. You can also go over here to the magnifying glass tool and use that to zoom in. So what we're going to do is we're going to expand these little drop-down menus. Anything with that warning sign there is just to tell you that the text is missing, so it's okay. I'm going to go ahead and expand all of this down just so that we can see what's in all of these files. That's completely acceptable. This is your file, you can do that. Right here, the other one is the other piece of text. That is our phone number, but we're going to start here at the dental office. So let's select that layer so that we're working on that layer just itself. I'm going to bring up our dental or our text tool and highlight dental office. It's telling us that it's missing the font. That's okay. It's not a font I love, so we're going to switch that to, today we're going to use, let's go ahead and use Times New Roman. That's one that's on pretty much every computer. So we're going to use that. I'm going to zoom back out so you can see this a little easier so it's not quite so pixelated. So that says dental office. We're going to change it to Main Street Dental. That's going to be the name of my dental office today. Once that's done, go over to the second layer here where we have our phone number. It's the other one with the text. You notice that once we changed that text, it went back to a T. Here it's a T with a warning sign over it. So when we change that, that'll go away. But select that, bring your text tool over. There's your warning again. We're going to change this one to Times New Roman as well. Just for today, you can use whatever font you want. It's up to you. This is your project. But for me, today is Times New Roman. So here's our generic phone number. And that is a simple banner right there. So that's what that looks like. If you want to flatten it down to make it into a JPEG file, you're going to go to Flatten Image. It's under the Layers tab. So hit Flatten Image. Then you're going to go to Save As. And you're going to want to save it as whatever file you would like. We're going to save as Dentist banner. You want to save it as not a Photoshop document, but a JPEG document. You want that file extension to say .jpg, and that is a JPEG file. Another option that you can do are things like a PNG or even a BMP. Either of those formats will work, but JPEG is probably your best bet for now. So go ahead and save that. And for the web, I usually like to do it about a medium quality. It depends on what you're doing it for. You can always do it on maximum and scale it down, or you can save it as a lower quality file. It is up to you and what size requirements you have. For now, we're going to do a medium file, and that is your banner.